Hi, I'm Mary Poplin with Imagineer Systems, and today we're going to show you how to simplify complex removes. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to open Mocha and we're going to import our footage. We choose our footage from our browser, and once we have decided on our shot, we hit OK. In this case, I'm going to be removing a wire from this puppet shot, so the wire is controlling the hand and I want it gone. Now the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take an X-spline, and with my X-spline I'm going to draw around the hand. Now the reason I'm drawing around the hand first is because I actually need to hold the hand out from the wire in order to get a remove without any artifacts. This is because the remove needs to look at the pixels behind the wire, and it doesn't know the difference between foreground objects and background objects if I don't actually define them. We're going to track this shape forwards and backwards really quickly. And we're going to adjust our roto to make sure our roto is always around the shape, including the motion blur, because again, we don't want to leave pixels on the background. And because we're rotoscoping in Mocha, we're letting the track do most of the work for our roto. Once my roto is complete, I want to make a feathered edge. So I'm going to hit the Uber key, and I'm going to select Pick Edge, and I'm actually going to feather this out. I've turned the mat on so that you can see what this looks like. And we can turn that off when we're done with it so that I don't have to have it interfere with my roto. The reason I use Uber key is because it creates a ripple offset across all of the keyframes I've made on the roto, feathering the edge no matter what I've done to those points. Once we've held out the hand, we can name this our hand holdout, and then I actually need to make another holdout, so I'm going to take my X-spline and draw around this boy. This is because, again, I don't want to leave the boy's pixels on the background track that I'm using to replace the wire. We're going to track forwards and backwards really quickly and adjust any roto on the boy as well. Once we've done that, we can simply make a shape to track our background. And in this case, we drag it underneath the boy and hand. The reason we do this is because it allows us to track without those shapes interfering. The top of your layer pile should always be objects that are closest to the camera, and the objects at the bottom should always be objects that are furthest from the camera. This creates user-defined automatic holdouts based on layer order inside of Mocha. Now we can track forward. So now I need to define my wire. I'm going to draw a shape around my wire, and I'm going to drag my wire under my holdout shapes. I do this so that these are held out for my remove, making sure it's above the background layer. I then go to Link to Track, and I link the wire shape to my hand track. And then I correct my roto for my wire. Now, the important thing about this is that the wire is completely covered, including the motion blur, and the reason that it's important that it's above the background and below the holdouts is so the holdouts are held out from the remove, and it pulls all the pixels from the background shape. The other important element for a successful remove is that the background shape must be a rock-solid track, and the background shape must completely cover the shape of the object you're trying to remove, in this case, the wire. From there, I simply select the Remove module and I select my layer. I then hit Render Forwards. And just like that, the wire is removed automatically. If I need to export from the standalone, I can go to Export Rendered Clip. Once in Export Rendered Clip, I can choose a movie file and hit Save. In this case, we're going to do a QuickTime. And I hit OK. I can adjust my codec settings and hit Render. So here's what it looks like before and after. With experience and practice, you can actually use this to remove really complex puppet rigs. The same techniques apply to shots like this from The Wizard of Oz, where they were actually doing complex rig removal. The important part is getting an accurate track on background pixels and using accurate roto on foreground elements, including the object you're trying to remove. I am Mary Poplin with Imagineer Systems. And if you have any questions, you can find out more on borisfx.com.